Students, we'll continue our session. We were discussing root 2 irrational number, that we can prove also root 3, root 5, root 7, any number, any irrational number you can prove by irrational. Take another example, suppose root 2 plus root 5 you want to prove irrational. Let us take this is equal to x, and x belongs to set of rational number. Squaring both will find out 2 plus 5 plus 2 into root 2 into root 5. That is equal to x square. So we'll find out 7 plus 2 root 10 is equal to x square, or 2 root 10 is equal to x square minus 7. Root 10 is equal to x square minus 7 by 2. Since x is rational, x square also rational, x square minus 7 is rational, and this also rational number. Whereas root 10 is product of root 2 into root 5, both are irrational and this also irrational number. Hence, you got LHS is not equal to RHS, that is a contrary statement. Our assumption that is irrational number is wrong. Hence, root 2 plus root 5 is irrational. Then, how can you find out irrational number between two given rational number? Say, for example, you want to insert the irrational number between, say, 4 by 9 and 7 by 11. Express this in terms of decimals. So you will be getting this is 0.4 bar and this we are getting 0.64 bar. It means this number goes 0.444 up to infinite. This is 0.646464 up to infinite. Number lying between, say, you can take here 0.551235, any number you can take. Any number of numbers you can select from between this and find out the irrational number between them. Find the 6 irrational number between 2 given irrational numbers. Say root 3 and root 7 are 2 irrational numbers given. You want to find out 10 irrational number. For that, root 3, as you know, it is from 3 and squaring both will find out 7. Therefore, you can place a 0 here. This is place a 0 here. So 3.1, 3.2, up to 3.2, 3.3, any number. 4.1, 5.1, 6.1, any number of irrational number you can find out in between them. Then comes rationalization. Rationalization, it is a process of converting irrational number to rational number. So say for example root 3, what is the rationalizing factor of making this rational? If multiplied by root 3, it becomes 3. Hence root 3 is called the rationalizing factor of irrational number root 3. Say for example 2 by root 5, if you want to rationalize the denominator, what to do? So you have to multiply by root 5, both happen numerator and denominator, you will be getting that root 2 root 5 by 5. So this becomes rationalized denominator. Say for example another number, say 1 by root 3, 2 plus root 3, you want to rationalize the denominator. So multiply by 2 minus root 3 to both numerator and the denominator, you will be getting 2 minus root 3 by 2 square minus root 3 square. So that it becomes 2 minus root 3 by 4 minus 3 is equal to 2 minus root 3 by 1, or 2 minus root 3 is required rationalized denominator number. Okay, then for simplifying, a question can be also, you can use any number. Just to see, a question from our textbook, you can obtain also to prove this one. If it is given 5 plus 2 root 3 by 7 plus 4 root 3 is equal to a minus b root 3. Find the value of a and b. For that, rationalize the denominator. So 5 plus 2 root 3, it is given 7 plus 4 root 3. So multiply by 7 minus 4 root 3 by 7 plus 4 root 3 into 7 minus 4 root 3 is equal to a minus b root 3. So that upper one, when you multiply 5 into 7, 35, 5 into 4 minus 20 root 3, 2 into 7 plus 14 root 3, 2 root 3 into 4, 2 into 4, 8 into 3, 24 minus 24. By the 7 square is 49 and 4 root 3 square is minus 16 into 3, 48. A square minus B square. Because A plus B into A minus B, so A square minus B square. That is equal to 35 minus 24 is 11. 20 root 3 plus 14 is minus 7 root 3. By 14, 8, 9 minus 48 is 1, is equal to A minus B root 3. So compare this value, A is equal to 11, minus 7 root 3 is equal to minus B root 3. Therefore, root 3 cancel, B minus cancel, B is equal to 7. Therefore, A is equal to 11, B is equal to 7. Thank you for watching this chapter.